Ladies and gentlemen, so I'll be going straight on evaluation of rootstocks in the Witzenberg Valley. And at this point, I'll say it is very important to start by mentioning how we classify rootstocks based on vigor, tree size. And today what we are going to see all the way is some of the rootstocks which we are evaluating, the latest one, which we have the Geneva 890 and the Geneva 969, which are the latest, and we are going to discuss that today. And what we have, our objectives when it comes to this is we farm on M109, M793, and M7. And we farm on these rootstocks. We have been farming on these rootstocks for many years, and we understand them better, and we know how to manage them. But now it is time that we evaluate other rootstocks, mostly the Geneva rootstocks. And also another point is to evaluate more dwarfing rootstocks than the current South African standards which we have. And doing that, we went straight to Witzenberg, Paretkloof. I think we still have the problem with the light. That side, sir? Yeah. The light again. Yes, thank you. So we use different planting densities, different vigorous, where we have the semi-vigorous and dwarfing. We use different plant densities. And what we observed at this point is, if you look at cumulative yield efficiency on Rosset Law, is if you look carefully, you see we have our MM109. So what we have here is the bubble size. So the bubble size indicates the cumulative yield. So if you have a small bubble size, that you don't have much cumulative yield. But a moment when you have a bigger bubble size, it indicates that you have more, you have accumulated high yields. So what we are farming on is the MM109, like I said, and M793, and as well as M7. And here we have cumulative yield efficiency. So what we look at the sound diameters, you find that our rootstocks, which we know how to farm on, say MM109, M793, are not that yield efficient. But if you look again, even when you look at MM109, compare it with 778, which is on the same vigor class, you'll find that 778 is doing much better than MM109. Again, if you look at M793, you find that if you see M793 and if you compare it to 228, you see that 228 is doing much better than M793. And for the first time, which for especially in 2017, we did not expect to see Lancep landing there. So I asked myself, what is happening? But nevertheless, what is happening is that when you use M9 RN29, which is M9 NIC29, you find it to be much more yield efficient. So we got much cumulative yield efficiency. So what can we conclude, as may have seen, that if you use these rootstocks, especially on MM109, CG934, and Geneva 778, we can increase the spacing, planting it at 4 meter by 1.5, and we can also decrease the plant spacing on intermediate. And going down where we have the 222, the MM109, M9, we can also work on our plant spacing. And if we do consider one day where we go for high density plantings, we see that we can play with M9, NIC29 on say planting at 3 meter by 1 meter. And that's for the Witzenberg Valley.